start with him, Ryan. Tough times. What's the bull case here for crypto?
Yeah, I mean, I missed the party last year, I guess.
Yeah, sorry.
but it's a heck of a lot easier to come on TV when the price is trading down 85% in some respects. I think if you look at the long-term fundamentals of this asset class, things haven't really changed. We've seen Bitcoin get a little bit more resilient, a little stronger, thanks to some of the challenges of the past year. Layer 2 scaling solutions like Lightning, which facilitate smaller and much more rapid payments, have come online. We've seen challenges from the Bitcoin hard fork kind of dissipate. At one point towards the end of last year, Bitcoin Cash was about 30% of the Bitcoin network. Now that ecosystem has had some infighting and has fallen down to a combined 7%. And if you look at the developer activity and just the institutional interest in building tools that make this asset class more accessible, those have all improved drastically over the course of the past year. So price has fallen. It's done this about 4 or 5 times, 80 to 90% corrections. If you look at any other time scale aside from just the last 12 months, this has been one of the top performing assets in the world.
Mike, when you're looking at trying to do technical analysis, it's incredibly hard. There aren't many fundamentals to even go off when it comes to cryptocurrencies. When you're looking at Bitcoin, for example, we got Tom Lee, who's over at Fundstrat, who's saying, you know, I'm still seeing a much higher overall fair price, fair value price. Where do you see fair value when it comes to, in particular, Bitcoin?
Good question. I like to look at the migration process, and it's very important to recognize what just Ryan has said. This is the past when the market was for the select few. Now it's institutionalized. We're having more regulation, adult supervision, futures, options, even the Bloomberg Galaxy Crypto Index. So the market's changed, and for my key level I've been looking for over years is a base. Where's the base for Bitcoin? And I still look around 1,500 or so. That's been the continuous mean. That's Bitcoin alone.
So if more to fall, basically.
More to fall, but getting closer. But a lot of the indications are showing it's really getting close to forming that base. Indications are getting where oversold, and finally seeing supply decline come off a little bit. I mean, overall supply, but overall, and the key thing I want to watch is I need to see volatility get to new lows. Last time volatility, 180-day volatility bottom at the low was 41%. That was October 2015. That marked the beginning of the bull market. It needs to go to new lows and probably stay there for a while.
I got a question for everybody, though.
So that's unfortunate. He's predicting that Bitcoin will hit 1,500 and then stabilize, which means you got another 50% hit coming to people who are deciding to buy in at the 3,000 range. I don't know if he's correct, but I am going to go in with the mindset that this is something that could possibly happen. So I've unfortunately invested a good amount of cryptocurrency, and I would say my average buy is the 6,000 range. So I'm absolutely crushed in cryptos and especially the altcoins. So it's a really tough pill to swallow. Fortunately, it's all capital that I can sit and patiently wait. And I am going to still put aside some money to continue to buy the dip. So if the price goes down to 2,000 or 1,500, I do have cash that I will be converting into crypto. So let me know your thoughts on this, and I will talk to you soon.
Thank you for watching. Subscribe for the next video. If you like the video, please give me a thumb up. watching. Subscribe for the next video. If you like the video, please give me a thumb up.